I think that there's a really, really exciting future ahead for anybody who wants to get involved in this space.
What if I smack you up?
Yeah, of course. You know, we're going to have to attract over 300,000 more people into the sector. I'm Dhara Vyas. I am the Chief Executive of Energy UK. Energy UK is the trade association for the energy industry in the UK. The skills gap, when we're talking about it in the energy sector, is the difference between the sorts of jobs and skills we need to deliver on our ambitions versus what we have available right now. But we need to make sure we've got the people who can actually do the work and get it done. What we really need in this sector is people who are sort of level 2, 3, 4 apprentices, and that's not necessarily a degree level academic qualification. We need lots of people working in all sorts of different jobs. So yes, we need welders. Yes, we need engineers. Yes, we need project managers, but we also need lawyers, planners. We need people who can do policy and regulation. We need comms people. We need all sorts of skills to make sure we can do this right. Clean power by 2030 is a really exciting ambition. We are going to be attracting about £40 billion of investment every year between now and 2030. And to get there, we are going to have to massively expand and increase and modernise our grid and make sure we can move clean power around the country in a really efficient, smart way. So we do need to invest in clean power generation. We need to invest in onshore wind turbines. We need to invest in onshore solar. We need to really invest in offshore wind. That's going to be the backbone of our system. We're going to have to build out pylons and underground cables, high voltage cables all around the country so that we can move energy around in a really smart, efficient way. But we're also going to have to really increase electrification. So for me, this is all about government and industry working in partnership. It's about making sure the conditions are there so that businesses can bring new ideas and different innovative products to people and people have choice. And ultimately, what we want is cleaner transport and warm, safe, comfortable homes. I think we've got a lot to do when it comes to the workforce, and I would actually look out to 2050, really, because between now and 2030, we've probably got about 80% of the people we need in the workforce. So it is about retraining, reskilling, particularly from some of the fossil fuel-based jobs, where I think there is a really, really good trajectory and huge options for people who want to work in that space and move into clean energy. But going out to 2050, you know, we're going to have to attract over 300,000 more people into the sector. I think that there's a really, really exciting future ahead for anybody who wants to get involved in this space. I think, you know, people who are starting their careers today and even people who are working today, there is no one career trajectory. You're going to have lots and lots of different options available to you at different points. If you're interested in working in clean energy, the energy transition, ask questions, look around, approach companies. Companies are really, really interested in making sure we're attracting young people into our sector, get to the career fairs, and also, you know, look up networks like our Young Energy Professionals Network. There's so many opportunities out there, and they are not just graduate jobs.